Hepatitis C virus reproduces in the liver, causing inflammation and possibly cirrhosis, liver failure, or liver cancer, much like hepatitis B virus. However, HCV is different with its own traits. A person may be infected and have no signs or symptoms and can live with the virus for decades without even knowing it, while the virus does damage to the liver. About 80% of the people exposed develop a chronic infection. Remember, that means long-term. Only about 20% are able to clear the virus by naturally building immunities. There are about 3.2 million people in the USA infected with hepatitis C virus, with about 17,000 new cases each year. Deaths from chronic disease each year total approximately 12,000 people. Symptoms are not a reliable way to detect hepatitis C either. A blood test is usually needed. And if symptoms appear, they may look the same as hepatitis B, which again would include the yellow skin, otherwise known as jaundice, yellowing eyes, tiredness, loss of appetite, nausea, dark urine, joint pain, abdominal discomfort, and fever. Unlike HIV or HBV, HCV is spread primarily through contact with the blood of an infected person through needles. Hepatitis C virus is most commonly spread by sharing needles for injecting drugs. That's currently the most common means of HCV transmission in the U.S. Receipt of donated blood or blood products and organs. Once it was a common means of transmission, but now, due to the fact that there's much more screening available, it's much less a risk. Birth to an HCV-infected mother, needle stick injuries in healthcare settings, although this is also a low percentage of how HCV infections occur, and unlike HIV and HBV, hepatitis C is spread less frequently through sexual contact or sharing personal items contaminated with infectious blood, such as razors and toothbrushes. HIV-infected people face a much greater risk of HCV infection due to an already suppressed immune system. Now, there's no evidence of HCV transmission from food handlers, teachers, or other service providers in the absence of blood-to-blood contact. But like HIV and hepatitis B, it is not spread by casual contact like handshakes, hugging, doorknobs, or using the same equipment like toilets or water fountains, unless there's contaminated waste on those objects. There is no cure for hepatitis C, and today there is still no vaccination.